Yeah, you got a good sized class.
That's great.
Good evening.
Hey.
My name is Daryl Hewels, and I will be your moderator for this class. Welcome to a lecture presented by members of the IDMR. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a non-denominational, nonprofit, religious and scientific research organization dedicated to showing the proof of the existence of Yahweh or Elohim, the operation of his eternal purpose and pattern and plan, and operating throughout eternity to this present day. The school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the year 1931. And we were incorporated in the state of California in the year 1958. We hold classes in the United States and certain other foreign countries. In this school, we use the true, correct, and original name and title of the Father, the Word or Son, and the Holy Spirit as they are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted with Lord. The true title of the Word or Son is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted with God. And the name of the Holy Spirit, manifested in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted with Jesus Christ. Now, Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are lords many and gods many. But we now know that each lord must have a name and each god must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. That means Elohim is the title that our Creator chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part into a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language contain any character or letter in their alphabet which would make the sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1,400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings of the true and correct name of our Heavenly Father and His Son. Christ is a title, just like Lord and God. Now, Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, He is incomprehensible and inscrutable. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh in this pure spirit state, symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh's not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. We have this cloud drawn all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart is within the cloud. In like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Now, Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and took on form right within himself as Elohim, the Word or Son, a super incorporeal being, that is, having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. And this form can only be seen in divine visions and understood through divine revelation. Later on, the self-same spirit manifested in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua, the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now, there's only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. So the simple yet intelligent question that we should all ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Messiah during the time that he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, he called Moses atop Mount Sinai and showed him this tabernacle pattern in a vision. Yahweh later instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The tabernacle pattern consists, of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court roundabout. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. In this school, we show proof that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. Our 10 primary constitutional aims and objectives are as follows. First is to help you find know Yahweh our Elohim as he really is and actually exists. Second is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah without distinction of nationality, race, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third is to investigate the unexplained spirit law or so-called law of nature and the powers latent in man. Fourth is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religion, psychology, philosophy, and modern both practical and occult science. Fifth is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Sixth is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. Seventh is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, or Satan and his demons operating the mystery of iniquity through the dispensations of time. Eighth is to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered unto the sons or children of Yahweh. Ninth is to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained that there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved, save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And tenth is to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is to speak the truth. We're going to begin today's class with a prayer by Dr. Kim Faulkner. That will be followed by a selection from our choir. And then after that, the scripture lesson will be Romans, the first chapter. And the scripture will be read by Dr. Kathy Hewells.
Let's all bow our hearts and minds to our Heavenly Father, Yahshua. We thank you for the opportunity to learn something of you. We thank you for your witnesses. We thank you for you coming down and being salvation and breaking yourself down so each and every one of us can understand your purpose. We thank you for this creation that we walk about in that continues to reveal those mysteries of you, that without your divine revelation and you having put your spirit within us, we wouldn't understand a lot of what happens in this earth plane. There's so many that walk about in it and they have no idea the rhyme and the reason of how you have this thing put together, both physically and spiritually. Through your son's great name, Yahshua the Messiah, let us all say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
From a Holy Name Bible containing the Holy Name version of the Old and New Testaments, critically compared with ancient authorities and various manuscripts revised by the late A.B. Trina from the Scripture Research Association, College Park, Maryland, copyright 1963. Romans, the first chapter. Saul, a servant of Yahshua the Messiah, called to be an apostle, separated unto the glad tidings, or the gospel, of Yahweh, which he had promised afore by his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, concerning his son Yahshua the Messiah, our Savior, who is made of the seed of David according to the flesh, and declared to be the Son of Yahweh with power, according to the Spirit of holiness, by the resurrection from the dead, by whom we have received grace and apostleship, for obedience to the faith among all nations for his name, among whom are ye also the called of Yahshua the Messiah, to all that be in Rome, beloved of Yahweh, called to be sons. Grace to you and peace from Yahweh our Father and Yahshua the Messiah. First, I thank my Elohim through Yahshua the Messiah for you all, that your faith is spoken of throughout the whole world. For Yahweh is my witness, whom I serve with my spirit in the glad tidings of his Son, that without ceasing I make mention of you always in my prayers, making request, if by any means now at length I might have a prosperous journey by the will of Yahweh to come unto you. For I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift, to the end you may be established. That is, that I may be comforted together with you by the mutual faith, both of you and me. Now I would not have you ignorant, brethren, that oftentimes I purposed to come unto you, but was hindered hitherto, that I might have some fruit among you also, even as among other nations. I am a debtor both to the Greeks and to other nations, both to the wise and to the unwise. So as much as is in me, I am ready to preach the glad tidings to you that are at Rome also. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah, for it is the power of Yahweh unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. For the wrath of Yahweh shall be revealed from heaven against all impiety and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Because that which may be known of Yahweh is manifest in them, for Yahweh has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and supernal nature, so that they are without excuse. Because that when they knew Yahweh, they glorified him not as Elohim, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools, and changed the glory of the uncorruptible Elohim into an image made like unto corruptible man, and to birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things. Wherefore Yahweh also gave them up to uncleanness through the lusts of their own hearts to dishonor their own bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of Yahweh into a lie and worshipped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. For this cause Yahweh gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the women, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men doing that which is indecent, and repents of their error, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was proper. And even as they did not like to retain Yahweh in their knowledge, Yahweh gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not proper, being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of Yahweh, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful, who knowing the judgment of Yahweh, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but consent with them that do them. Romans, the first chapter. Hallelujah.
I'd like to say I welcome our visitors, the Dean of Arkport class, Bonnie Snyder, and class the other class members. Thank you for coming. It's so nice to have you here. Give us some people. I'd like to call for our first speaker, the Dean of the Arkport class, Dr. Bonnie Snyder.
I hope you don't mind if I don't come back here.
No, I'm actually, as soon as I sit down.
I only use it to cover up my rolls.
As soon as I sit down, I'm taking mine off.
You're fine.
There you go.
I don't really have anything particular on my mind. I'm glad to be here. Always happy and glad to be at class and to testify to the things that I've learned in this great school. And let's go right to the scripture reading and start at 1, and I'll talk about the gospel a little bit, see where it goes. I might not be up too long. We'll see what happens.
Romans 1st chapter.
Saul,
or Paul, a servant of Yahshua the Messiah.
So Paul, and he's writing right at the beginning of the self-same age that we're in right now. Isn't that right?
Yes.
So the things that he's teaching, you know, there was a message that Noah had right here at the end of this age. Mm-hmm. And there's a message here that Yahshua the Messiah had to wait on the Holy Spirit. That was the message, the wait for the promise, see? And then there's a message at the end of this age. So what you have is the self-same thing that was being taught at the beginning of the age should be what's being taught at the end of the age.
That's right.
I mean, when did Noah change his mind and change the message, you understand?
That's right.
And even Yahshua, he came in, Galatians 4 and 4, and then we'll go back to where I am now.
Galatians 4, verse 4.
Mm-hmm.
But when the fullness of the time was come.
Now, when the fullness of time was come, read.
Yahweh set forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law.
So Yahshua the Messiah came in, and he was made under the law. He was born of a woman, made under the law, right? So this whole time period here is when the law was written and when the prophets were written, that's the time that Yahshua the Messiah came in. So this whole time period, there was one teaching. See what I mean?
Yes.
And so this whole time period, there should be one teaching. Mm-hmm. All right, so that was the point there. Go ahead and read, please, where you were.
Romans 1.
Yep, start. Yeah. Start at 1 again.
1. Paul, a servant of Yahshua the Messiah, called to be an apostle, separated unto the gospel of Yahweh.
So he was separated unto the gospel of Yahshua. Read.
Which he promised afore by his prophets in the Holy Scriptures.
So the scriptures, which are the law and the testimony, see? It's the scriptures of the law and the testimony that testified of what Yahshua the Messiah was going to do when he came in. That's what they were written for. Keep reading, please.
Which he had promised afore by his prophets in the Holy Scriptures.
That's
concerning
right.
Concerning his son Yahshua, our Savior.
So all the scriptures were concerning. You know what that word means, right?
Yes. Yeah.
They're concerning. They're all about Yahshua. In fact, the whole creation that we live in is all about one manifestation or another of Yahshua, or the purpose of Yahweh.
Yes.
The whole creation that we live in, and then Dr. Kinley called the Bible the biblical creation.
That's right.
And so you have the creation and the biblical creation testifying to the things that Yahshua the Messiah do, or they're really concerning Yahshua. In that aspect, this whole purpose of Yahweh is not about you. It's really about Yahshua the Messiah. But he did it for you.
Right.
You understand?
Yes.
And I want to get this quick. Go to Revelation and stay where you are, Kathy. Rohan, please go to...
I have to get it. It won't pick up.
Oh, okay. All right. That's okay.
Revelation
1 and 5.
Revelation 1 and 5.
I think.
For Mike, for the recording.
And from Yahshua the Messiah, who was the faithful witness,
uh-huh,
and the first begotten of the dead,
uh-huh, read,
and the prince of the kings of the earth.
Okay, so the revelation that John is receiving, Yahweh Elohim or Yahshua is telling him something about himself.
Mm-hmm.
So about Yahshua the Messiah, prince of the kings of the earth. Read, please.
And unto him that loved us.
Now look at, unto him that loved us. Read.
Yes. And
when did he start loving you? Well, if you look at the way that he was the lamb, see, in Moses' vision, he sees that he's a lamb slain right from the foundation of the world. He comes on into shape and form. That's a death, folks. Mm-hmm. He's the lamb right there. And it's pointing out, and it has to be fulfilled down here, but you have it happening up here. So right here is where that love started. When he came forth, the purpose is already in motion.
That's right.
See what I mean?
Yep.
All right, read. Start that again, please, where you were.
Unto him that loved us.
Unto him that loved us, read.
And washed us from our sins.
And look it, he loved us and he washed us from our sins when he, go ahead and read.
In his own blood.
In his own blood. So the creator of the universe comes on down the physical body, dies for the sin of the world, and washes you in his blood if you believe what he has done. Right. You understand? It's already been taken care of when you even were born. Yeah. If you believe what he said. If you believe what the witnesses show. You understand? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, now keep reading where you were, Kathy.
Okay. Romans, the first chapter.
Read.
1:3. Concerning his son, Yahshua, our Savior, which was made of the seed of David according to the flesh.
So these things were concerning Yahshua, the Messiah. All right, now go to 16.
Romans 1:16.
Mm-hmm.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of the Messiah.
So Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Yahshua, the Messiah. I'm not ashamed. And Dr. Kinley said, not one little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't say that just one time. Many times he said that.
Mm-hmm.
That he wasn't ashamed, not one little bit. And why would you be ashamed of the power of Yahweh?
Right.
You understand? But go ahead and keep reading.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. For
right.
It is the power of Yahweh unto salvation to everyone that believeth.
So the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah is the power of Yahweh. And you know that Yahweh is attributes. Isn't that right?
Yes.
And we've looked at this, but we would have never known what Yahweh was. We'd be just like everybody else out there in the world saying, God is spirit, and spirit is God.
Yeah.
Don't know what spirit is and don't know what God is.
Right.
You understand?
Yes.
But Yahweh is spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the attributes of spirit is power. And the gospel that he came in, and it's really also the gospel of the kingdom.
Yes.
And the kingdom was set up before we came in on the scene.
That's
See,
right.
We didn't have a whole lot to do with any of this, folks.
That's right.
See? So anyway, you have Yahshua the Messiah coming in here and going through a death, a burial, a resurrection, ascension, and pouring out the Holy Spirit. And that was in fulfillment of a promise given way back here to Abraham.
Yep.
So what you have is Yahshua's death, burial, resurrection. That's the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. And Paul says, and you know Paul's a big guy out there in the world.
Yes.
Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
And I've been overseas, and I've seen the churches over in England, and the churches, and they got a St. Paul's everywhere. And you know, and they listen to Paul, and they listen to Peter, and they listen to, but you know what? They don't pick up on the gospel that he was preaching.
Right.
And he preached it from the beginning of his ministry until the end of his ministry.
Right.
And you read through that last chapter of Acts and
mm-hmm.
see what it was that he was teaching. I'm going to do that, but I want you to keep reading where you are first. Let's finish up this 16.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah.
So he's not ashamed of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. Read, please.
For it is the power of Yahweh
uh-huh.
unto salvation.
So the gospel of Yahweh is the power of Yahweh unto salvation. Salvation. Salvation of what?
The soul.
Salvation of the soul. We are, you see, this school is in this.
Yes.
This school is about the soul.
That's
it's about
right.
the inner man. It's about the
That's right.
spirit that you, that had the shape and form, the things that Yahweh has given you, a person,
yep.
is your soul,
mm-hmm.
your attributes, your nature,
yes.
your capacity of learning.
Yep.
That's your soul, folks.
Right.
And that's something that was given to you by the one that died for you.
That's right.
Gave it to you as a gift, just
That's right
here.
Right.
Take this. This is your. This is yours.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all that you have to do.
Yep.
To receive it
mm-hmm.
is just take it.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yep.
That's it.
Yep.
Just take
right.
it in.
That's right.
Now that's something, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
All right. Keep reading.
For it is the power of Yahweh unto salvation to everyone that believeth,
mm-hmm.
to the Jew first and also to the Greek.
So the Jews and the Gentiles, because after Yahshua goes through his death, burial, and resurrection, see, the first covenant back here was given to the Jews and the Jews only.
Right.
In fact, this covenant that was given back here, these things that are practiced out there in Christianity were never given to you as a Gentile.
Right.
They were for the Jews and the Jews only.
Mm-hmm.
Christianity picked them up and practiced them, but they were never given to them.
Mm-hmm.
These were not imposed on you, Gentiles.
Right.
You mm-hmm. understand? Mm-hmm. So you have both now, after Yahshua goes through his death, burial, and resurrection, then you have both Jew and Gentile brought together in one in Yahshua the Messiah.
Right.
And it was proven back here. See, the promise to Abraham, you don't have it on this chart, but there was a promise given to Abraham. Right. And
it's on this one over here, underneath the...
Okay, there was a promise given to Abraham back here. And it was, the promise was, in his seed, all nations would be blessed.
Right.
So when Yahshua the Messiah comes in, that's the seed that he's talking about, all
right?
That's right. So Yahshua the Messiah fulfills that promise in pouring out his spirit in the hearts and minds of the Jews,
yes.
and then 7 years later on the Gentiles.
Right.
And then that promise is fulfilled. It's for Jew and Gentiles.
That's right.
For therein is the... Well, read. Keep reading.
For therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from faith to faith.
For therein, and he's talking about the gospel.
Yep.
In the gospel
mm-hmm.
is what?
The righteousness,
the righteousness of Yahweh
revealed.
And you know, I hope I'm not screaming in this thing. Okay. I know I get...
Me too.
You know, the righteousness of Yahweh, a lot of times we come into class and we bring a lot of stuff in with us, folks. We got a lot of stuff in our heart. And, you know, we just do.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes a lot of teaching and a lot of looking at things and a lot of experience to get rid of, let's hope, a lot of the stuff that wasn't right. Well, none of it was right. But see, what happens is a word like righteousness, we don't know what that means.
Uh-huh.
We don't understand what's... And a lot of times, this is what we think righteousness is.
Yeah.
Being pious and holy.
Uh-huh.
And trying to do everything just right. And, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And see, what's right in Yahweh's eyesight, if you look right here on this, this is what's righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a picture in there. This is depicting Yahshua the Messiah. And this is depicting the bride of Yahshua the Messiah. And what is right in Yahshua's eyesight is that he has given his spirit to a group of people. That's his bride. That's what righteousness is. Therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from faith to faith. What does that mean? You have faith and you have faith. You see, we all have something. Yahweh's given a gift of something to us.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, and then you have righteousness right here on the altar. And so what it is that the bride has to believe before she can even start up is that Yahshua the Messiah died to take away sin.
Yes, right.
You see where? That's
yes.
right where it starts. Now, that's your righteousness.
That's right.
You haven't got any of your own.
Right.
You understand?
Yep.
Your righteousness is what he has done.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So anyway, that keep reading, please, Kathy.
Right.
17 again.
For therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from
faith
to
faith. So therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from faith to faith. Read.
As it is written, the just shall live by faith.
As it is written back in the Old Testament, the just are going to live by faith.
That's right.
But they couldn't start living by faith until faith was poured out.
Mm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And faith is not just blind, like,
right.
and just, oh, I believe it because my dean says so, or I believe it because Rohan says it and he can talk
right.
fast. You understand? It's not anything like that. It's the what faith is the witnesses that Yahweh
yes.
has set to show forth his own purpose.
Mm-hmm.
All the things that he put in this creation that witness to him, such as water. Such water.
Mm.
You know, I don't know if you've heard, but they're saying out there in California now that water's not a witness.
No.
But anyway, you have water vapor, likened unto pure spirit here.
Right.
Yahweh taking on incorporeal shape and form. That's the witness to that is water takes on the shape and form when it's condensed down of the container that it's in. Can
mm-hmm.
you see that? Do you
yeah.
know that's the same H2O in there?
Yeah.
That's in the room that we're in?
That's right.
It's not a different molecule. It's H2O.
That's right.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
See? And then the self-same Yahweh takes on a physical body, walks around on the earth plane for 33 and a half years. And that's not even the first time he's been here.
That's
See, he
right.
was back here as Yahshua. Yeah. There's no Jay, there's no Jesus. Who do you think that was back there being a minister?
Right.
See what I mean? And who'd have the right to minister to them back there?
That's right.
See?
That's right.
So anyway, you got Yahshua the Messiah. And that's like that ice coming on down.
Mm-hmm.
And you know the example, and this is a beautiful example. And it's worthy of going and repeating these great examples. Because you know what? These confirming witnesses cause you to stand in Yahshua and be strong.
That's
and
right.
we need these things.
Yes.
To be remain, just like Dr. Kinley said, come to class, be on time. Learn all you can. You're going to need it.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to need these things. You're
going
to need to know why you're standing in truth.
That's
and
right.
it's through the witnesses that you're standing in truth.
That's right.
And so this is what, just like that, he died at 33.
Mm-hmm.
Ice goes back at 33
That's
degrees.
Right.
See what I mean?
Yes.
Back into this state.
Yep.
Now that's something else.
Yeah, it is.
Who could dream up such a thing? No scientist could dream that stuff up.
Mm-mm.
You can't make up the truth.
Yeah, really.
You understand that? It's so perfect and lined up. You can't, and you can't improve on it.
Nope.
See? Best thing you can do is just, if you believe it, repeat it just the way that it is.
Yeah.
See what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So he's the righteous of Yahweh from faith to faith.
Mm-hmm.
Read, keep reading.
For the just shall live by faith, as it is written. The just shall live by faith.
Read.
For the wrath of Yahweh is
now,
revealed from heaven.
So I just want to talk about the gospel a little bit.
Okay.
Because you have, let's go to 1 Corinthians 15 also.
1 Corinthians 15, 1.
Uh-huh.
Moreover, brethren.
Now this is Paul again. He's also talking right at the beginning of the age that we're in right now. Moreover, brethren. Read.
I declare unto you the gospel.
So Paul's declaring something unto them. And you know, even the way this book is put together, and sometimes we just take it for granted. We come in, we listen to these things like they're a sing song. But you know what? Even the way that he says things, I declare unto you the gospel. Now see, if I'm coming along and I'm going to tell Kim something, if I'm just going to tell her, oh, you know, I went for a walk today, took the kids, went to Stony Brook. That's not declaring.
Right.
That's just talking.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
But if I'm going to say here, you know what? They got class over to Wellsville.
Yeah.
You want to go over there on Monday? Now that's a declaration. Do you see the difference?
Yeah.
And when he declared something, and that's not even as important as what we're talking about here. You understand?
Yes.
When he's declaring something, this declaration is important. You don't just declare something, and a lot of times a declaration in the old, when they used to do the old laws, they'd go out there before they had computers and stuff, you know, back in the 1800s and stuff, they'd go out there, they'd have a town crier, and he'd declare what the laws were, and he'd declare what things were. See, there was a declaration that took place. There's something in these words, folks, and he's declaring unto them what the gospel is. Now, if somebody declares something unto you, and it's Yahweh, because look at self-same spirit that's in Paul right at the beginning of this age. He got the spirit. See, the spirit was poured out, and look at all through this age. And sometimes there's a bird on this age right here.
Mm.
All through this age, the Holy Spirit is being poured out.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
So Paul's got the Holy Spirit. So when he's declaring something, it's really Yahweh declaring this unto you.
That's right.
And you want to listen to what it is that Yahweh says.
Mm-hmm.
And you think about all the things that we've gone into our whole life. And listen. Now you're a doctor, isn't that right? You got a doctor's degree. You've done some listening in your day. And repeating, too. But he's done a lot of listening. And you do a job where you... Do them women talk when you're doing their nails? You know women talk when you're doing... That's right. So you're listening and you're listening and you're listening. When you give haircuts, are they just about talking? Yeah, it's a confessional down there where he works. But you see what I mean? We have listened. We've listened. We turn the TV on and we listen to... whichever news you happen to like. If you like Fox, you love, I don't know who'd listen to that, but anyway, then you listen to CNN, or you listen to things.
Yeah.
we listen. How about listening to what thus saith Yahweh? Now that would give a listen, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. Wouldn't that be something?
Yeah.
Read.
Moreover, brethren, I declare.
So he's going to declare, so you listen. Read.
The gospel.
He's declaring the gospel. And you know that the gospel is yet. Keep reading. Let's read through this.
Which I preached unto you, mm-hmm. which also you have received, and wherein you stand.
Read.
By which also you are saved, mm-hmm. if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless you have believed in vain.
Read.
For I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received, mm-hmm. how that the Messiah died for our sins, according to the Scriptures.
Okay, so he's saying what the gospel is how the Messiah died for our sins.
Right.
Don't want to forget that part. Not just right. he died, but he died for our sins, according to the Scriptures, or according to, or in agreement with what was written in the law and what was written in the testimony.
Yes.
And those things testify of him. Mm-hmm. And that's what the gospel is. And that gospel is the power of Yahweh. Mm-hmm. See how important it is?
Yep.
Unto salvation. And you know what? You can't escape the gospel, even if you've never heard it.
Yep.
Didn't the sun come up this morning?
Yep.
That's preaching the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah.
That's right.
The sun comes up, resurrects, doesn't it? Yeah. Well, last night the sun went down.
Yeah.
And it's going down now out there. Sun goes down, hidden under the horizon, or buried, isn't that right? Death, burial. Very early in the morning it resurrects. And you're expecting that resurrection. You got things to do tomorrow.
Yep.
You got a list.
Yep.
Isn't that right?
Absolutely.
See? So the creation that you live in is telling you there's a death, burial, and resurrection.
Right.
Keep reading.
For I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received, how that the Messiah died for our sins according to the Scriptures.
So he died for our sins according to the Scriptures. Read,
and
please.
That he was buried.
And that he was buried.
And
see.
That he rose again the third day.
And that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. Or what was written in the law and what was written in the testimony. And what was written in the creation.
Right.
Don't you know that there was a death here? The earth was inundated in water.
Yeah.
It was in a death-like, chaotic state. Mm-hmm. So you got a death. Isn't it buried in the water?
Yeah.
Burial. Third day, mm-hmm. dry land appears, or there's a resurrection. Death, burial, resurrection. Mm-hmm. Right in your creation. Mm-hmm. Isn't that right? And then you go three more days, there's another resurrection when Yahshua comes up. Isn't that right? You got death, burial, and resurrection again. Yeah. No wonder Paul says again from the dead.
Yeah.
See what I mean? Look at, there was two sacrifices here every day, the death of the
That's
lamb.
Right.
They sacrificed one in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Death, isn't that right?
Yes.
He died he was on the altar. He was buried in that laver.
Yes.
And he resurrected to come in there and take the blood where it was supposed to go. Death, burial, resurrection. And then the evening sacrifice, death, burial, and resurrection again. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Right.
This thing comes together so tight you can't do anything with it
right.
if you just stick to the truth.
Right.
See what I mean? So you've got death, burial, and resurrection. And that's the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. Yeah. And if you look over here, see, let's go ahead and get this too. Let's get 1 John 5:7.
1 John 5:7.
Mm-hmm.
For there are three that bear record in heaven.
Now look it. There's three that bear record in heaven. There's three that bear record in heaven. Who are these three? Read.
The Father.
The Father.
The Word.
The Word.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit manifest in or out of the physical body. Isn't that right? Isn't that what the Holy Spirit is? That's what Yahshua is?
Yes.
Well, I thought you were down here on earth. He said, there's three that bear record in heaven. See, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit, they never leave heaven.
Right.
Because heaven is not a place, folks.
Right.
It's a state of mind.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
He never has been dead.
No.
Because it's a state of mind.
Yes.
See? So you got the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And these three are one.
Right.
They're one spirit.
Right.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
Read, please.
And there are three that bear witness in earth.
And there's three that bear witness in the earth. Read.
The spirit.
The spirit.
And the water.
And the water.
And the blood.
And the blood.
And these three agree in one.
And these three agree in one. These three are one. These three agree in one. What are they agreeing to?
Yahshua.
They're agreeing that Yahshua is one. You understand? That's what the agreement's all about around here. That's what the according's all about. You see what I mean?
Yes.
That's what the agreement's all about. But anyway, mm-hmm. It's the Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua. These three are one. And you have it witnessed right here by this tabernacle pattern.
Yes.
By the way, Yahweh, Elohim shows Moses himself.
Mm-hmm.
This is what Moses sees in the vision. See, there's a reason why these charts are made the way they are.
Mm-hmm.
This part that's light right here, this is what Moses is seeing in his vision.
Right.
He sees Yahweh Elohim.
Mm-hmm.
He sees the tabernacle pattern. He sees Yahweh Elohim transmute himself into the days of creation
right.
according to the tabernacle pattern.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I mean? So when you've got him being the pattern, when he's told to come down here and build it in the wilderness of Sinai, if there's three yet one in Yahweh's spirit, because
yes.
it's Yahweh.
Right.
See what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Or Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua. These three are one. Then, of course, the tabernacle is going to be that way to verify how he is.
Yes.
This is an expression of him.
That's right.
See?
Yep.
So you've got a most holy place, a court roundabout. And these three are one.
Mm-hmm.
And right here in this court roundabout area of the pattern, you've got the death. Or you've got blood there with the
yes.
with the death of the lamb. You got blood, you got water in the laver, you got spirit with the holy anointing oil. Blood, water, spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
And that's the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah
that's
too.
Right.
You've got that blood, that water, that spirit, see? Because
yes.
those are the things that are going to bear witness to Yahshua the Messiah on earth.
Mm-hmm.
So you come over here, see? And you got, didn't Adam, see? Didn't he... Well, let's see. I always get mixed up with the Adam thing. But you have Adam. what is it, Rohan?
His death caused blood.
His death caused blood on all mankind. See? Then he had to work by the sweat of his face. Blood, water. Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
And the spirit had closed that door. Blood, water, spirit. Also, you had a promise there with them that in childbearing they would be saved.
That's right.
That's spirit. Promise is a spirit.
Yep.
Or promise.
Yeah.
Promises that's a spiritual principle, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So then you come over here with Noah. Didn't he have a vision of the flood?
Yes.
See? And he preached, he got the blood off his head.
Yes.
That's in Ezekiel 33rd chapter. So you got blood there, isn't
yes.
that right?
Yes.
Blood. And he had a vision of the flood, that's water. And then a spirit, see, closed the door. Blood, water, spirit. And didn't it rain 40 days and 40 nights? And look at, according to Dr. Kent, according to Moses' vision back here, they were in the garden 40 days. See?
Yeah.
So you got 40 here and you got 40 here.
That's right.
And you hear with the children of Israel, see? They had the death of the lamb before they could leave Egypt. That's blood, isn't that right?
Yeah.
They went through the parted waters of the Red Sea. Blood, water. Didn't they follow the cloud?
Yes.
Spirit, see what I mean? And
yes.
they were had to dwell in the wilderness 40 years.
That's right.
Blood, water, spirit, 40. Blood, water, spirit, 40. Blood, water, spirit, 40.
Yep.
Now that's a song.
That's
isn't that right?
Song.
See what I mean? And it comes right from the tabernacle pattern. Then Yahshua the Messiah, he's pointed out as the Lamb of Yahweh. And you know that lamb had to die, and that's a blood. He also came in a flesh and blood body.
Right.
See? So you got blood. And wasn't he baptized unto John?
Yes.
So you got blood. You got water. Didn't the Spirit descend on him as a dove?
Yes.
Blood, water, Spirit. How many days did he fast?
40
days. He fasted in the wilderness. Isn't that right?
Yes.
And it's right out of this pattern of spirit, water, blood. Blood, water, spirit, 40. Blood, water, spirit, 40. And you come down here, Yahshua goes through his actual death. He's dead. Isn't that right?
Yes.
See? He's buried in the tomb. You got dead. Blood. And look it. When they killed him, they pierced him, and out came blood and water. Blood. Water, isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost, spirit.
Right.
Blood, water, spirit. Isn't that right?
Yep.
And he tarried on earth 40 days. Blood,
yep.
water, spirit, 40.
Right.
Isn't that right? See?
Yes.
And you have here, look at, you keep going down there. This pattern works, folks.
Yes.
This is the pattern of him.
Yes.
This is his pattern.
Yes.
This is how he operates. And you have to believe in the operation mm-hmm. of the eternal purpose, which he has within himself. You got to look at the things that he did or you can't believe what he's doing.
Right.
You see what I mean?
Yes.
Okay, so here you got You've got the blood. Let's see. Okay, the blood of the New Testament, my blood. Okay, he prophesied the New Testament is blood. You also had them, he washed the disciples' feet.
Yep.
Blood, water, right? And then was it June 6th was 40 days after then? I don't know what the 40 is here, but you got blood, water, spirit there. You have the same thing here. You've got, is this Stephen?
Yep.
So you got Stephen being stoned. You got the Ethiopian eunuch being baptized. So you've got blood. You have water. Isn't that right? Mm-hmm. And the spirit took him away. Blood, water, spirit. Mm-hmm. And you see, you know, and these two, and you know that physical water baptism, after Yahshua the Messiah comes in and fulfills it, it was no longer good even for a Jew. Physical right. water baptism.
Right.
But isn't this something that because Yahweh did the purpose that he had two baptisms right here? Mm-hmm. There's a pattern in operation, folks.
Oh, yeah.
And you know that if you look at the vision the way it was, Moses saw the vision from beginning to ending. Isn't that right?
Yes.
And John saw the vision from beginning to end. Do you think Moses saw this? Do you think this was, he might have seen this?
Yes.
Same vision we're having.
Yes, he did.
You see what I mean? And even though it was after Pentecost, there was going to be a type of a water there.
Yes.
See, so you got water there. And you can explain why it's not right, too. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's right on the chart and it's right in the purpose. But it's not right for salvation.
Right.
Sorry, anyway, you got blood, water, spirit. Then you got James being beheaded. Isn't that right?
Yep.
Peter goes and says, can any man forbid water? So you got blood and water. Mm-hmm. And then the Holy Spirit's poured out on the Gentiles. Mm-hmm. And then Christianity comes in. They're built guilty of the blood of Yahshua the Messiah by keeping the ordinances. See, guilty of his blood. See, they practice physical water baptism. Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you got a raven right here. That's what this represents right here. You got a raven right there, which was a evil bird or a dark spirit, see? And it really is, Yahshua is the only way, the truth, and the life. That's the spirit that we should be looking at. But down here, they also go by a pattern, blood, water, and spirit. See what I mean? And so you got all the way through there. Now I want to go to
Acts 28:21.
And I'm going to read through to the end of this, so just be patient. I'm almost done because I'm hot.
And they said unto him, mm-hmm. We neither received letters out of Judea concerning thee, neither any of the brethren that came showed or spake any harm of thee, but we desire to hear of thee what thou thinkest.
For okay, now they're talking about Paul right here at the beginning of this age. We desire to hear what you're thinking about, Paul. We didn't get any letters about you, but we want to know what you're thinking. Go ahead and read, please.
For concerning this sect.
Concerning this sect of whom? People that believe in Yahshua the Messiah's death, burial, and resurrection according to the scriptures. And the name of Yahweh.
Right.
Elohim and Yahshua. Now that's a sect. Read.
We know that everywhere it is spoken against.
Everywhere it's spoken against. So don't be surprised.
Really.
Just preach it for all you got and don't worry about it. Read on.
And when they had appointed him a day.
And look at when they appointed Paul a day. Read.
There came many to him into his lodging.
There came many to him into his lodging. Read, please.
To whom he expounded.
Uh-huh.
And testified.
So this is what Paul was doing. This is how he was telling what he was thinking. He expounded unto them. And you know expounded, that's another word you want to think about. It's not just, he just told them.
No.
You know what? Yahshua came in.
No.
You know that guy that was living around here about 30 years ago? That's not what he was doing. He was expounding unto them. Or he was showing them point by point the things that Yahshua the Messiah had done according to the scriptures. And look at, you can keep going up the tabernacle.
Yes.
See what I mean?
Uh-huh.
You know that he's the light of the world. You know he's our only sustenance. You know he's the only intercessor.
Yes.
You know he's the veil.
Yes.
See what I mean? You can keep going up with it.
Yes.
Keep reading.
And when they had appointed him a day, there mm-hmm. came many to him into his lodging, to whom he expounded and testified the kingdom of Yahweh.
So Paul expounded and testified the kingdom of Yahweh. And by the way, Yahshua called death, burial, resurrection the gospel of the kingdom.
That's right.
So you want to be in the kingdom, you might want to understand a little something about the gospel of the kingdom. Or the good news or the glad tidings of this kingdom.
That's right.
Because it's showing you what Yahshua the Messiah did for all of us.
Yes.
Showing you something, see?
Yes.
And how he really is.
Yes.
The love that he has.
Yes.
Did he come down and die to take away sin? Mm-hmm. See? Mm-hmm. And that he'd have offspring in the first place to deal with? You know, some people don't want to bother with kids. Even naturally so. It's okay. I don't care. One way or the other.
Right.
That's just a natural example.
Yep.
But it does take a lot of steam to have kids.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't end but when they leave the house, does it, Kat?
No.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
It takes a lot of steam.
Yeah.
Got to have some little bit of stick to it.
Gotcha.
Yes. Yeah. You got to stick to it. Okay, Reed.
That's true. And he expounded and testified the kingdom of Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
Persuading them concerning Yahshua.
So he was going to persuade them concerning Yahshua. Read.
Both out of the law of Moses,
which is just what you do when you preach the gospel.
That's
You're trying to convince them that this is the one. This is the one that came all the way down.
That's right.
It's not Lord God Jesus.
No.
It's not somebody that, it's not, you know, you had Janies and Jambries back here.
Right.
It wasn't somebody that could just do tricks. It wasn't a liar.
Right.
He can't lie.
That's right.
It wasn't somebody that was going to say something along. Oh, okay, let's see. I'll try to think of a great example here. Let's say this. We're going to have class in Arkport. We're going to have class there every you know, couple times a week. We're going to have class. Now, that started way back in 2000. And we've been having class twice a week for the most part since 2000. And I'm saying we're going to have class there. Whether I'm dead or alive, we'll have class there.
Right.
You understand? And this is the point. If I come along and say, you know, it's really not necessary that we have class there. Well, what kind of story would that be? I'd be changing the story. Because I do think it's necessary that you have the information available to the public. And I'm glad you're over here preaching.
Yep.
See?
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad you're here preaching it. Because you never can tell.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe somebody will come in.
That's right.
See? Read.
Persuading them.
So he's persuading them concerning
Yahshua. Both out of the law of Moses and out of the prophets. From morning till evening.
Read, please.
And some believe the things which were spoken.
And some believe what he said when he taught them from morning till evening.
Yes.
He got into a lot of things with them.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
He knew something.
Yes, indeed.
See? So he talks to them from morning till evening. And some believed.
Yes.
And some didn't. Go ahead and read.
And when they agreed not among themselves, they departed after that Paul had spoken one word.
Uh-huh.
Well spake the Holy Spirit by Isaiah the prophet unto our fathers, saying, Go unto this people and say, hearing you shall hear and shall not understand.
That's right. Keep reading.
And seeing you shall see and not perceive.
Yep, read.
For the heart of this people is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing, and their eyes have they closed.
You know darn well when you go out in the world and talk to people about this, how they are.
They
don't care. You could talk to them about anything.
Yeah.
You could talk to them about what Oprah said yesterday, or you could talk to them about running, or you could talk to them about the makeup that you wear, or you could talk to them, what kind of glasses do you like?
Yeah.
Or you could talk to them about, oh, my vegetable garden. Well, you ought to see the flowers that I grow.
Mm-hmm.
You could talk to them, and they'd listen.
Yes, That's right.
Would you like to hear something about Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua, the one that created this creation? I got to go. I'll see you later. I don't know why you're always trying to tell me something about that. For 40 years you've been trying to tell me that. Somebody told me just the other day. And I had somebody, one of the first people that came to class from Arkport, way back when we were in Arkport, before, she came to class for about, I think about a year. She said to me the other day, I saw her at a party, a graduation party. She said, do you still go to that Yahweh church? I said, well, I still go to class. It's a class, remember? She says, oh, I don't go to anything. I says, well, maybe you ought to think about coming down there and trying it again. And she said, no. She said, I pray to Yahweh and Yahshua every night. And she said, and I'm not interested in learning anything or, you know, doing any more or anything. And I'm like, well, you're praying to somebody you don't know then. You might as well just pray to Lord God and Jesus. She says, that's not very nice. I like that name, Yahweh. I says, yeah, but you don't know anything about him. But anyway, she remembered all that time. So that was, anyway, keep reading so I can get off this floor. Go ahead and read.
Mm-hmm. For the heart of the people is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing.
And they're dull of hearing. They don't want to hear the truth. See, read.
And their eyes have they closed, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their heart and should be converted.
And look at, if they understood with their heart, they'd be converted. And converted means they change. Yes. They change in their heart and mind. Mm-hmm. See? They go from being carnal, physical, natural, earthly, because that's what we all came in with,
just
a carnal mind.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what Dr. Kidley said about a carnal mind. He said it was a terrible plague.
Yeah.
So you don't want to end up with that when the end comes.
Really?
You don't want to be in a plague when the end comes. You understand? You want to be up out of that thing. That's Go ahead and
right.
read.
That's right. Be it known therefore unto you.
Now be it known therefore unto you that the salvation
of
Israel.
Yahweh.
Read.
Is sent unto the Gentiles.
Is sent unto the Gentiles also. For it's the Jews and Gentiles. That's what the promise was. See, read.
And that they will hear it.
And you know what? They're going to hear it. Israel waxed cold against Yahweh, but the Gentiles were going to hear it. Go ahead and read.
And when he had said these words, the Jews departed and had great reasoning among themselves.
Uh-huh.
And Paul dwelt 2 whole years in his own hired house and received all that came in unto him.
Uh-huh, read.
Preaching the kingdom of Yahweh.
So what Paul was preaching for 2 whole years was the kingdom of Yahweh. You think he was preaching the gospel of Yahshua?
Yeah, gospel of the kingdom.
Read.
And teaching those things which concern Yahshua, our Savior, with all confidence.
With
no
all confidence.
Forbidding him.
That's right. See? With those few words of encouragement, I hope somebody got something out of that.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Very much enjoyed that. Remarks of our first speaker. I'm going to call for our second speaker, Dr. Kim Faulkner.
I enjoyed the remarks of the previous speaker, and it certainly is an honor and a privilege to be able to testify to the things that Yahshua has shown us through the years of coming into this school, that they weren't just in naught. And I especially appreciate 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, I guess, if anything. Right along with Paul Cook, it's one of my songs. Because I can remember it being said sometimes in the Institute, don't get so-and-so up because they just preach the same thing. But that's what gives us our stability in this creation, is that repetition and that constant repeating and repeating and repeating.
Yep.
And we know, I'll just get Romans. It was our scripture reading, Romans 1:19 and 20.
Because that which may be known of Yahweh is manifest in them, for Yahweh has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead. So that they are without excuse.
His eternal power and Godhead, something can be known about it, so they're without excuse.
That's right.
And today, one of the things that I was actually pondering on was in Hornell on August 1st, they're going to have a monarch festival. And it's been on the radio, and they advertise it. First, I have to draw your attention to this wall. I just was in awe when I came here last week. Comfort care, just like we remarked when we entered the comfort inn, that in the hospitality room for all of us sick people. And it's just amazing. It's just amazing what Yahshua does in the flesh to reinforce what Bonnie was talking about with these attributes. and that one being strength. And he being the only thing right about you was that he died for you.
Yep.
You can't even do nothing right. It's just amazing. Mm-hmm. Back to the monarch. Mm-hmm. It's no wonder they're becoming extinct. Mm-hmm. The monarchs are becoming extinct. Mm-hmm. And I mentioned this to somebody recently at the nail salon. Mm-hmm. And they were like, so are the honeybees.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Why would you figure? The monarchs are becoming extinct because of everything being sprayed on the milkweed. Mm-hmm. They're poisoning their food. Mm-hmm. They're starving. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And with the honeybees, same idea. And one of my clients said, we're killing ourselves off. Little do they know, because they don't know. Mm-hmm. They weren't given this gift. Mm-hmm. That it all fits. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to be this way. Mm-hmm. From something as simple as the monarch and the honeybee, but in the bigger picture, we know only a few made it over into Canaan's land.
That's right.
And as Bonnie was talking about, all of this being set up to point out this one spirit, this lamb slain from the foundation of the earth, the one who came down and fulfilled, as the gospel was saying, that death, burial, resurrection, according to the scriptures. You know, we saw it with our brethren Noah. We saw it with our brethren Jonah. We saw it with our brethren and the children of Israel. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Right.
We're given that key to understand how Yahshua set all of this up and all of this up to witness to him, not only down through the law and the prophets, but also in the creation, to point him out how he really is salvation. And many times, I brought it out last week, I just, it just is like, it's overwhelming. I mean, in the big picture, how Yahshua has done all of this so that after his death, burial, resurrection, and his blood going retroactive and cleansing you,
yep.
That's what makes you his bride or right in him.
Yep.
I don't really have a whole lot more on my mind other than I thought that was beautiful that it was a twofold witness with the monarch and the honeybee, mm-hmm. because we know this was called the land flowing with milk and honey.
Yeah.
And fellow sister Tracy Wilcox had sent me some information on the Dark Act that's been passed, denying the Americans the right to know what's in their food. And I'd brought this out with one of the previous classes here, but I thought, wow, what another witness in this earth plane, how this mystery of iniquity doesn't want you to know. And I personally hadn't heard the information about being taught in LA that now they're throwing out the example of water. It's just, but we know Yahshua, and he's going to contend for that truth, you know. That gospel that will be declared, expounded on. Mm-hmm. Oh, he has a purpose to cause doubt. And I had listened to something on YouTube from it's either Oceanside or Lansing, with that mystery of iniquity, how doubt causes you to be down and out or without a hope.
Yeah.
And what's that? No, no. And Yahshua doesn't work that way. We are so blessed. We are so lucky that Yahshua works with witnesses. Because if you've ever worked with somebody that doesn't, run. Just run. You know, you do it when you buy a car. You do it as a nail tech. If their nails keep peeling, they's not coming back. I'm telling you, they're finding a new tech. They're not going to pay me $40 and have their stuff off in 2 days. And every now and then you run into a glitch. Maybe your lights weren't strong enough. Maybe they got into some cleaning things they really shouldn't have without gloves, you know. But you prove it. You prove all things. You find out what the culprit was that attacked the polish, if you will. And correct it. Just like Yahshua's gospel will correct. The truth will overcome a lie. It's amazing. He's the father of darkness. A match will overcome a dark room. That one little glimpse of truth will always overcome darkness. He says, I am Yahweh and I change not. He's going to continue to be all of these attributes.
That's right.
Power, justice, strength, foundation. When a house, I'm looking for the body. Oh, when a house is built on a good foundation, or a house, or the cinder blocks going to build on a good foundation, there's no storm going to rock that. And when Yahshua has set up a good work in you, when he's made you right, when his blood, with the outpouring of his Holy Spirit, has been put within you, there's no storm going to rock that. There's not going to be doubt. He can't overcome. And it's only with that spirit of truth put within us that we're able to decipher such a lie as he's only saving himself or water's no longer a witness. You go back. You go back to the fundamentals. You go back to what you were first taught when you came into these classes.
That's right.
You go back to that death, burial, resurrection. You go back to that blood, water, spirit. You go back to the body tabernacle and you see all these correlations, but they're your very foundation. You go back to that name and how you walk around in this earth plane with Yah written on your face. Every time you look in a mirror, they're all witnesses. They're all witnesses to reinforce what our first speaker was saying, that his blood does the cleansing. His blood is what makes you right.
Yeah.
And with that Holy Spirit in you, you can contend for that common salvation. You will have that strength, that power, the love of the truth, because that's the only attribute he's missing is the love. And as we walk around in the year 2015 and all of these things keep coming together with the monarch and the honeybee and many other different examples. We just constantly say, thank you, Yahshua. Thank you, Yahshua, for keeping me. Why aren't I one of the ones no longer coming here? Why aren't I one of the ones sucked in? It's only your will. And with that, I just say thank you, Yahshua, for keeping me each and every day. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you very much. You have to take advantage of having people here, so I'm going to call for our next speaker, Dr. Rohan Ross.
Good evening, class.
Hey.
Good evening, sir.
My head is large. It's good to be in class once again. I did enjoy the two speakers, previous speaker. And we know that there's only one teacher, right? And that's Yahshua. And back then they had schools. Get Acts 19 and 9. See, John 14, verse 26.
Acts 19, 9, John 14.
And why do we come to school? To learn, right?
Yes.
You know, they say we can't learn. And what kind of school is that? If you have a teacher, you have students, and you can't learn. That doesn't make any sense, does it? Acts 19 and 9.
Acts 19, verse 9.
Yeah.
But when divers were hardened and believed not, but spake evil of that way before the multitude, he departed from them and separated the disciples, disputing daily in the school.
So by, at the beginning of the age, there were many disputes in the schools. So what's going on now? Because Yahweh declares the end right from the what?
Yes.
The beginning, there has to be many disputes in the schools.
Yes.
Now, what was the dispute? What was the dispute or the debate about? Doctrine.
Oh yeah.
All right. Let's prove that. Get Acts 15 and 1.
Okay. Acts 15 and 1.
Yeah. And it was among the Jews.
Yes.
See, now we're Israel now. See.
Yes.
And that's why that which was then is what now.
Now.
See. Read.
Acts 15, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
And certain men which came down from Judea taught the brethren and said, except you be circumcised after the manner of Moses, you cannot be saved.
Now, who were these? These were Jews. They were trying to put them back under the law.
Right.
So here again, at the beginning of the age, they had disputes are about doctrine, about mixing up the old covenant and trying to drag that over here, saying you have
right.
to be circumcised physically.
Yeah.
At the beginning of the age.
That's right.
Yahweh declares the what? The end, right from the what? The beginning. Read on.
Except you be circumcised after the manner of Moses, you cannot be saved.
Read.
When therefore Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and disputation with them.
No, what is a dissension?
They disagree.
That's an argument. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. So,
by the beginning of the age, there are dissensions and disputations about doctrine.
Yes.
So what do you think is going to happen though at the end of the age? There's going to be what? And it says they had no small dissension or disputation. So in other words, it wasn't a small argument. It was a big argument.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And it is it's a warfare against the truth versus the lie.
Sure.
You see? Because Yahshua, see, all right, okay. So that's what's going on. Now at the beginning of the age, they did not want them preaching the name Yahshua.
That's right.
Read Acts 4, verse 18.
See? Acts 4, verse 18.
Yeah.
And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of Yahshua. And I'm going to go to 2, verse 2.
Verse
Acts 4, 2.
Yeah.
I'm going to start at 1. And as they spake unto the people, the priests
yes.
and the captain of the temple, and the Sadducees came unto them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached through Yahshua the resurrection from the dead.
Can you imagine that? Who were these people? They were Jews. That were religious leaders that were angry because they were preaching Yahshua
yes.
and the resurrection of the dead.
That's right.
All you got to do is read a little bit. Because Yahweh declares the what? The end right from the beginning. It's the same thing going on.
Yes.
Now, one is not an Israelite, which is one what? Outwardly. But one is we're in Israel now.
Yes.
And that's the same. So that if these things didn't happen, we would not be in the truth.
That's right.
But Yahweh's purpose just repeats itself.
Uh-huh.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Great disputation at the beginning of the age. Great
yes.
disputation at the end of the age.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
See?
Mm-hmm.
Don't preach in the name Yahshua at the beginning of the age. What? Same thing now.
Yeah.
Salvation is in Dr. Kinley. That's not correct.
No.
Salvation is only in the name of Yahshua. See? All right. 528. See?
Acts 528.
So if you want to comprehend what's going on at the end of the age,
oh, yeah.
just read what transpired at the beginning of the age.
Mm-hmm.
See?
I'm going to pick it up at 527.
27, read.
And when they had brought them, they set them before the council, and the high priest asked them. Uh-huh. He's talking about the disciples.
The high priest asked the disciples, read.
Saying, did not we straightly command you that you should not teach in this name?
No, who was the high priest? Israel's leaders.
Yes.
Israel's leaders did not want them preaching the name Yahshua.
Yeah.
To the point that they beat them and put them in prison.
Mm-hmm.
Leaders of Israel did that. Don't right. preach the name Yahshua at the beginning of the age. So what's going on now? Same thing. Because didn't Dr. King say this takes our picture? Get 1 Corinthians 10:11.
1 Corinthians 10, verse 11.
Yeah.
Now, can't quote it. Now, all these things happened unto them for examples, and they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come.
No, did it say?
In verse 6, it says, now these things were our examples.
Examples.
To the intent that we should not lust after evil things, as they also lusted. No, it's talking about the children of Israel.
Israel. No, it says, they're example upon whom the ends, E-N-D-S.
Yes.
Plural.
Yes.
Off the what?
World, are come.
Are, that's still plural.
Yes, really.
Come. Because the world ended three times already.
Yes.
What are you talking about?
Yep.
Right here at the flood, that was the end of the world. Mm-hmm. Genesis 6 and 5.
Mm-hmm.
Yahweh said, the end of all flesh will come.
Mm-hmm. No.
No, he didn't say that.
Is.
The end of all flesh is come.
Yes.
So as far as Yahweh is concerned, when he gave Noah the vision, that was the end of the world.
That's right.
So what you're going to do is you're going to see what's going to transpire at the end of the world. See?
Mm-hmm.
Read Genesis 6 and 5. We're at the end of the world. That's why these things are occurring.
Yeah.
And they're right on time.
Mm-hmm.
See?
Genesis 6 and
5. 6 and
5,
read.
And Elohim saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually.
So there was a lot of wicked imagination. Just
yes.
listen. At the end of a world.
Yes.
Now, when are you going to come telling me that Dr. Kinley is the name of salvation? That's a wicked imagination.
That's right.
When are you going to say your soul is a demon? That's a wicked imagination, but it's right on time.
Yep.
Every, not some. That's
right.
How bad it was.
That's
imagination
right.
of the thoughts, and that's all that is an imagination. If it's not by this divine pattern or standard,
mm-hmm.
or to the law and to the prophet, outside of that, it's an imagination.
That's right.
See? And it's evil.
Only
wicked
evil.
Imagination. Only evil continually. See? And that's the end of a world. But see, what's transpiring is that Yahweh is giving us the signs.
Yes.
What shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?
Yes.
And that's where you're at. That's why all this erroneous doctrine is being preached in the
yes.
school. See? Read 11. It's a serious thing. But so it must happen this way.
And the earth also, this is Genesis 6 and 11.
11.
The earth also was corrupt before Yahweh Elohim,
uh-huh.
and the earth was filled with violence.
No, this earth's not filled with violence, but man was made from the what? The dust of the earth, is that right?
Yes.
That's the earth that's filled with violence.
Yes.
You know, so the troopers running down, man, this physical earth here, you're under arrest for child molestation. Or, you see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Put the cuffs on that earth. No, it's not about mankind. Is that right? See, filled with violence. See, every imagination of the thoughts of his heart are evil what? Continually.
Mm-hmm.
See, then Yahshua said, get Matthew 12, where it says, as it was in the days of Noah.
Matthew 24:36.
So shall it be at the end. Is that right? See, we're talking about the end of the world and what are the signs? Imagination, false teaching.
37.
See?
But as the days of Noah were, so also shall the coming of the Son of Man be.
Read.
For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away.
So now, one second there. They were marrying and giving in marriages. That's divorce, right?
Yep.
All right. So when we came to class, a lot of us came with Jesus. So we're so-called married to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
it was proven that the letter J is only 400 years old, so that was taken away. We divorced that. We were married to Yahshua. Not the one who married to us to Kinley. Marrying, giving it. You see what I'm talking about? At the end of a world. Read on. See? Read. It just repeats itself. It's just those who have an eyes to see.
Yes.
See? Read
on. And they knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
Okay. Now at the end of this world, there was a flood. Is that right?
Yes.
At the end of this world, there was a flood.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Because what do you think? Right. What brought Pentecost was a flood of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. See? And that's what ended the what? Post-diluvian began the present kingdom work.
Yes.
Now, there's going to be a flood at the end of this one.
Yep.
A fire. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
See? It's going to set, but not of water. Is that right? See?
Right.
So the end of each world has a flood. Now, guess what? Doctrine is a flood.
Yes.
Water, it represents, get Isaiah 29 and 11.
Yes.
You see?
Isaiah 29.
And 11.
And 11.
Yeah. See? False teaching.
And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed.
Yeah.
Which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this,
which
I
book?
Pray thee.
The law and the prophets.
Yes, that's right.
You had plenty of time to study it and read it, and to learn read it. He said, I don't understand it. Mm-hmm. It was given to the unlearned. He said, I still don't understand it. Mm-hmm. Read.
And the vision of all has become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I cannot, for it is sealed.
It's sealed.
And the book is delivered to him that is learned, that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I am not learned.
No, it wasn't until 1931 that Yahshua the Messiah really loosed the seals. We
yes,
know that, right?
Right? Yes.
That's the one that loosed the seals.
Yes.
The opening and closing of the seals, Dr. Kinley says, the opening and closing of the ages and what? Dispensations. See, there are seven what? Dispensations,
yep.
Seven what? Ages.
Seals.
How many steps in the tabernacle?
Seven.
Seven steps, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
So now opening and closing of the seals.
Yeah.
First seal, second seal, third seal, fourth seal, fifth
yeah.
seal, sixth seal, seventh seal, the most holy place. Is that right?
Yep.
Are the opening and closing of the what? Ages and what? Dispensations. Is that right? And guess what? You had plenty of time to read it, but no, after the guy took off the flesh, no, everybody's an expert at it. Is that right? Yeah, you had plenty of time to explain it. How come you couldn't put this together before?
Yeah, really.
Now he took off the flesh, now you're an expert. And you're bigger than what he was teaching.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right. So we're working with the end of the world and what's going on. Get the 24th chapter of Matthew.
Matthew 24. Where do you want me to start?
One.
Matthew 24:1. And Yahshua went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple.
Read.
And Yahshua said unto them, see ye not all these things?
Okay. See ye not all these things? He's right by the temple. No, he was at the Herodian temple at the time.
Mm-hmm.
See, read.
Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down.
Read.
And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?
So listen to the question. The question is, what shall be the sign of thy coming
yep.
or the universal revelation of Yahshua
and the end.
And conjunction, the end of the world? So what is the sign of the end? Remember, that's the question, right?
Yes.
Listen to the first thing that comes out of his mouth in reply to that question. Or an answer to that question. Read.
And Yahshua answered.
This is the answer.
And said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
So what's the question? What are the signs of thy coming and of the end of the world? And the first thing that he replied in answering the question mm-hmm. is that, take heed that no man deceive you. That's giving you a clue that at the end of the world, someone's going to come along and try to deceive you.
That's right.
That's a sign of the coming and of the end of the world.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
read on. You see, it's right on time. So if something to come along try to deceive you at the end of the world, it wouldn't be time yet.
That's right.
So it's showing you what time you're at.
Yes. That's
right. You're at the end of the age.
Mm-hmm.
And it has to happen this way.
Yep.
See? Read on.
That's right.
Okay. Now, this was written 2,000 years ago, and it's up to date.
Right.
24th chapter of Matthew. Read.
And Yahshua answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
Read.
For many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Messiah.
Yeah.
And shall deceive many.
So many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Messiah, and shall deceive what?
Many.
Many. Is that going on?
Yes.
It sure is. See? Dr. Kinley is the Messiah. You know what I mean? Dr. Kinley is not. Yahshua is the Messiah.
That's right.
Listen, before Dr. Kinley existed, Yahshua existed.
Mm-hmm.
What's the difference? Yahshua does not have a soul to be saved.
That's right.
Dr. Kinley has a soul to be saved.
That's right.
Yahshua is the Savior.
That's right.
Doc said, it is as this vision revelation is for me as it is you. Is that right?
That's right.
See? No, it's the same spirit that was in here, but that doesn't, we're not worshiping a man. See,
right.
It's not about, get Numbers 23:19. See.
Numbers 23, verse 19.
Three.
Elohim is not a man
you
that he should lie.
Yahweh Elohim is not a man that he should lie. Read.
Neither the son of man that he should repent.
So to say Dr. Kinley tricked us, you're saying he lied to us.
Yep,
Yahweh, that's one thing he cannot do is lie.
That's right.
Why can't he lie? Because he's the spirit of truth.
That's right.
See?
Yes.
Yahweh can't lie, he can't change, he can't repent.
That's right.
Is that right?
Yes.
Numbers 23:19. Where's the other one? 1 Samuel what? It says, Yahweh is not a man that he should lie. Malachi 3:16, Yahweh.
Malachi 3:6.
I'm Yahweh, I change not. Is that right?
Yes.
First Titus 1:2, in which Yahweh Elohim, who cannot lie.
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Hebrews 6:18, by these two immutable things.
Yes.
The law and the prophets, which Elohim cannot lie.
Yes.
So you got several witnesses saying Yahweh Elohim cannot lie. Get Deuteronomy 32:4.
Deuteronomy 32, verse 4.
Read.
For he is the rock. His work is perfect.
Uh-huh.
For all his ways are judgment.
Read on.
An Elohim of truth and without iniquity, just and right is he.
Does that sound like somebody that would trick you or craft or subtle?
Nope.
No.
They have corrupted themselves.
He's the Elohim of what? Truth.
And without iniquity.
And without iniquity. Yahweh is not a man that he should lie.
No.
See? Get Psalm 117 and 2.
Psalm 117,
verse 2. Yeah.
For his merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of Yahweh endureth forever.
He is the spirit of truth. He cannot lie.
Yep.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
The truth of Yahweh endureth forever.
Yes.
Get Proverbs 16 and 6.
Proverbs 16 and 6. By mercy and truth, iniquity is purged.
Did you hear that? By mercy and truth, iniquity is purged. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Proverbs 23:23. Let's walk it. See? Now, if this is a lie, it's surely a consistent lie.
Yeah, right. Proverbs 23 and 23.
23:23.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
Hold on. Buy the truth and sell it not. Don't they try to sell you the truth, so-called?
Oh, yeah.
No, Yahshua said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Is that
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Didn't Judah sell him?
Yeah.
For 30 pieces of silver, so he tried to sell the truth.
He died.
There was a consequence to that. Is that right?
Yes.
Buy the truth and sell it not. Is that right?
Yes.
Yahweh called Jerusalem the city of truth. Zechariah 8 and 3.
Zechariah
8 and 3.
And 3.
And then the 16th verse.
See? And three. Thus saith Yahweh, I am returned unto Zion and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. And Jerusalem will be shall be called a city of truth.
No, that's gonna be the theme at Vanderkamp, right?
It's beautiful.
Heavenly Jerusalem. Why?
Yes,
because that's the city of truth. Jerusalem above, Jerusalem beneath.
I like it.
Jerusalem above is the mother of us all. Is that right? Why? Because that's when he poured out the Holy Spirit. Is that right?
Yes.
Pour it into the hearts and minds of mankind. That's Jerusalem above. Uh-huh. See, Jerusalem beneath is in bondage because that's the old covenant. See, yes. We're in heavenly Jerusalem. The new covenant
yes.
is the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. So that's why it says Jerusalem here. See?
Uh-huh.
And now that's why Paul writes in, it's called the city of truth, right?
Yeah.
In Hebrews 12 and 18.
Hebrews 12 and 18.
Yeah. See? Jerusalem shall be called the city of truth.
For you're not come unto the mount that might be touched.
Right. He's looking back
fire,
here, right? Read.
Nor into blackness and darkness and tempest and the sound of the trumpet and the voice of words, which voice they heard entreated that the word should not be spoken to them anymore, for they could not endure that which was commanded.
Read.
And if so much as a beast touched the mountain, it shall be stoned or thrust through with a dart.
So you're not coming to old Jerusalem anymore.
No.
You see what I'm saying? Or the speaking down of the old covenant. You see
right.
what Paul's looking at?
Mm-hmm.
But you are come unto the city of the living Elohim.
But you are come, verse
yeah.
22,
present
unto
tense.
Mount Zion.
Unto Mount Zion.
And unto the city of the living Elohim.
And he's not talking about a geographical location.
No. The heavenly.
Heavenly Jerusalem. Is that right? Where did
that?
That right, Jerusalem. Right here at the day of Pentecost. Is
yes.
that right?
And
outpouring of the Holy Spirit. See, woman clothed in the sun. That's heavenly Jerusalem.
Yes.
Is that right? To an innumerable what?
Company
of angels.
See?
Read on.
To the general assembly and church of the firstborn.
Yes, read.
Which are written in heaven.
Heaven.
And to Yahweh, the judge of all, and to the spirits of just men made perfect.
Which are written in heaven. Is that right? Moses
yes.
saw Yahweh Elohim as the book of life. Is that right? With all
yes.
the names written in that body of Yahweh Elohim.
That's
and when
right.
he came down, he said, when Israel corrupted themselves, he said, blot me out of the book which thou hast written. Is that right?
Yes.
And Yahweh said, whosoever sinneth against me, him will I blot out of the book
That's right.
which I have written.
Yes.
So you have a book written right here.
Yep.
That book is the book of life.
Yes.
That's Yahweh Elohim. See?
That's, right.
That's heavenly Jerusalem.
Mm.
That's the book of life.
Mm.
That's the book of Asher. That's the book of remembrance.
That's, right.
That's the book of the living. You understand what I'm talking
yeah.
about? It's the
uh-huh.
same book. It's the same one.
Yeah.
The city of the living Elohim. We're talking about down here. We're talking about Jerusalem above. See? Keep reading. 18 on down, 20, right down
22,
to 22.
But you are come unto the Mount Zion, unto the city of the living Elohim.
Yeah.
And heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels.
Heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. Read.
To the general assembly and church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven, and to Yahweh, the judge of all, and to the spirits of just men made perfect.
Perfect.
And to Yahshua, the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than that of Abel.
Now, didn't he sprinkle about the book and the people back here under the old covenant?
The blood.
Yeah. With blood, is that right? See? So now the preaching of the gospel, that's the sprinkling of the blood that brought in the new or the heavenly Jerusalem.
Right.
Yahshua's death, burial, resurrection, ascension, and outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Because
right.
the old covenant was dedicated with the blood of what? Bullocks, is that right?
Yes.
Bulls. 12. You understand? He set up 12 altars back here. Is that right? For the 12
mm-hmm.
children of Israel. And spoke, and he sprinkled about the people and the what? And the altar,
the
is that right? And the book, rather, see? So now, the old covenant was dedicated with the blood of animals,
yep.
testifying how that the new covenant is dedicated with the blood of Yahshua.
That's
so
right.
Yahshua's death, burial, resurrection, ascension, pouring out that Holy Spirit, that's heavenly Jerusalem,
yes.
an innumerable company of angels.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm talking about? That's what he's looking at. He's
yes.
looking at something.
That's
see?
Right.
Now, just as though the old covenant was dedicated with blood, the new covenant... Because where a testament is, there must also of what? Necessity be the death of a what?
Testator.
Is that right?
Yes.
So he had to shed his blood
yes.
that we might live.
Right.
See? Dr. Killer didn't die on the cross for no one. Yahshua did.
That's right.
You see?
Yep.
Read Galatians 4:22.
Can I finish there?
Finish reading that and then jump to 22.
See that you refuse not him that speaketh.
Read.
For if they escape not who refused him that spake on earth,
read.
How much more shall not we escape if we turn away him that speaketh from heaven?
From heaven. Now remember back here? It says it was the voice of a trumpet.
Yes.
You understand? It was so exceedingly loud. And Yahweh yes. didn't need any public address system right. or anything like that. You understand? Yahweh's spirit. So when he spoke, everyone heard him loud and clear in their cloud.
Yes.
Is that right? Read back there. It says it was so exceedingly loud. And they said, listen, 18. We can't take it, man. Uh-huh. You go up, Moses, and talk to him. Is that right? Because Moses had to what? Be an intercessor, a type of who? Yahshua is the only one, intercessor
yes.
between Yahweh and man. Is that right?
Yeah, it's Hebrews 12:19. The sound of the trumpet sound and the trumpet. Voice of the words, which voice that they heard entreated that the word should not be spoken to them anymore.
Anymore.
For they could not endure that which was commanded.
Because it was so exceedingly loud. It was like a trumpet. Get Exodus 19:16 to prove that.
All right.
So when Yahweh spoke from the mountain, it was 3 million people, or, you know, however many there was, you see?
19,
they heard him loud and clear.
And it came.
Why? Because you were speaking right within them. Is that right?
Yes.
See?
Exodus 19:16. And it came to pass on the third day in the morning that there were thunders and lightning and a thick cloud upon the mountain. And the voice of the trumpet.
Trumpet! Is that right?
Exceeding loud.
Exceeding loud.
So
is that,
that
right?
All people that was in the camp trembled.
They trembled. They couldn't take it. They said, Moses, you go up and talk to
yes.
him. Is that right?
Yes.
You see? Because
mm-hmm.
Moses is a type of Yahshua, the only intercessor between Yahweh and man.
Yes.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yes.
So guess what happened? So now just that was, you see, this is a type and a shadow back here. You
yeah.
understand? He's still thundering down with his trumpet. The trumpet, that's why you have this what? Buccinator.
Yes.
Muscle, is that right? Which means trumpet in your face, is that right?
Yes. Because
it's representing the preaching of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. He's thundering down. You understand?
Yes.
He's speaking that covenant right in your heart and in your
that's
mind.
Right.
See, Psalm 45:1. My tongue is the what? Pen of a what? Ready writer. See, back here, wasn't it written with the finger of the living Elohim?
Yes.
See, it was external to them. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
No, he's writing that new covenant in your heart and in your mind. That's the
yeah.
heavenly Jerusalem.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right, read Galatians 4:22.
Galatians 4:22.
Read. It's exciting, man.
Yes, it
see?
Is.
It really is. See? And the fifth feast day was called what? The Feast of Trumpets.
Oh, yeah.
The fifth step of the tabernacle is the what? The holy place. That's where we ought to be standing. Is that right? So the preaching of the gospel, death, burial, resurrection, that's what you're standing in. That's what gets you into the fifth step of the Ooh. Pattern. And the fifth feast day, which is the feast of what? Trumpets.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because what? I told you there were seven steps. So you have seven dispensations.
Mm-hmm.
And here, and on the fifth dispensation
Pentecost.
Here, that's Pentecost.
Mm-hmm.
And what gets you there is the preaching of Yahshua's death, mm-hmm. burial, resurrection. He's trumpeting. Is that right?
Yeah.
You understand? The preaching
yeah.
of the gospel is what? You understand? Yahshua's death, burial, resurrection, ascension, and the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the kingdom on spiritual kingdom on earth, spiritual assembly, body of Yahshua,
mm-hmm.
heavenly Jerusalem.
Yes.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
See? Read.
Galatians 4, I'm going to start at 21.
21.
Tell me, ye that desire to be under the law,
yeah.
do you not hear the law?
Read.
For it is written that Abraham had two sons.
Right.
The one by a bondmaid, the other by a free woman.
Hagar, the bondwoman, gender it to the old covenant that had Israel in bondage. Very
right.
simple. See? Read. Ishmael from the free woman through,
Isaac.
Sorry, Ishmael was of the bondwoman, is that right?
Yes.
That represented by that old covenant, Isaac from the free woman, Sarah, is that right?
Yes.
Represent the new covenant or
yep.
new Jerusalem. See, read.
Yes. For it is written that Abraham had two sons, the one by a bondwoman, the bondmaid, the
read.
Other by a free woman.
Free woman.
But he who was of the bondwoman was born after the flesh.
Right.
But he of the free woman was by promise.
Was by promise. Abrahamic promise.
Yes.
Now guess what? Before Isaac was born, Yahweh had to change Abraham. His name was Abraham. Is that right?
That's right.
A-B-R-A-M. And her name was what?
Sarai.
Sarai. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
So now what Yahweh did, Abraham, that's male. Sarah is what? Female, that's his wife. See, what Yahweh did was he put an H
yes.
in Abraham's name. That's an H here. And he put an H uh-huh. in Sarah's name. So that's two H's. Just like you have Yah, which is the uh-huh. masculine portion, that's one H. And then you have what? Way, uh-huh. which is the feminine portion, has another H. You see what I'm saying? Then life came. Is that right?
Yes.
See? And then, so there was a name change before who was born?
Isaac
was born. Why a name change? Because the old covenant was that was under the name Yahweh. Is that right? But the new covenant is now under the name of Yahshua. So that's why on the day of Pentecost, the name Yahshua had to be declared. You see what I'm saying? Because it's a different covenant.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying? That's what these things are, types, shadows, and what? Allegories.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
That's what it says in 24.
Keep reading.
Galatians 4:24. Which things are an allegory.
Allegory. Types and shadows.
Or these are the two covenants.
No, y'all want to shake your hand. Do I go down here and shake your shadow? Is that right? That's what this was. It's not real.
Yep.
I'm
or
right
these
here.
These are the two covenants.
These are the two covenants.
The one from the Mount Sinai, which genders to bondage, which is Hagar.
That's the old covenant. Had them in bondage. Is that right?
This Hagar is Mount Sinai in Arabia.
Hagar is Mount Sinai in Arabia.
And answers to Jerusalem, which now is in bondage with her children.
And Jerusalem, which now is, that's Jerusalem beneath.
Yes.
Earthly Jerusalem is in bondage with her children.
But
so let's look at the distinction. He's really likening it unto the two covenants.
That's right.
See? Read.
But Jerusalem, which is above,
Jerusalem
is free.
Above is the mother of us all.
Which is the mother of us all. It's free.
Free. Is that right?
Which
free
is the
woman.
Mother of us all.
You see? Mm-hmm. Read on.
For it is written, rejoice thou, barren, that bearest not. Break forth and cry.
Read.
That thou travailest not. For the desolate has many more children than she which has a husband.
Okay.
Now we, brethren, as Isaac was, are the children of the promise.
Promise. Now how old was Abraham when Yahweh made that promise to him?
100.
75 years old.
Oh, 75.
Get Genesis 12 and verse
right.
1. Or it might be the fourth verse.
Yeah.
He was 75 years old.
Yes, you're right.
See? Now why?
Genesis.
No, the 75 is of significance. Let's mm-hmm. have a read. See? That's when he was given that promise. See?
Right.
And it represents Jew and Gentile.
Yeah.
Genesis 12 and 4, I think it is.
Genesis 12 and 4.
Okay.
So Abraham.
No, you see, look at this chart, please. Abrahamic promise. Genesis 12, 1 through 3. It says promise fulfilled. You see what I'm saying? See the arrow?
Oh, yeah.
No, read on.
Yeah. And I will bless him that bless thee. Okay, 4. Genesis 12, 4. So Abraham departed as Yahweh had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran.
Why? Because when Yahshua died, buried, resurrected, and poured out the Holy Spirit, that was his 34th birthday. That was AD 34. 3 plus 4 is what? 7. Is that right?
Yep.
Then 7 years later, he poured it out on the Gentiles,
uh-huh.
AD 41. AD 41, 4 plus 1 is what? 5, that's 75 to fulfill the promise.
Ah.
On Jew and Gentile, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
You see? Promise fulfilled.
Yeah.
No, that Abrahamic promise was 430 years before the what? The law.
Yes.
And Paul wrote that the
That's
promise,
right.
the Mosaic law cannot make the promise of none effect.
Do you want it?
Find it, please.
Galatians 3.
3:16.
16.
Read.
Now to Abraham, it's past there, but I'm going to start here.
Read.
Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He uh-huh. saith not into seeds as of many,
right.
but as of one, and to thy seed, which is the Messiah.
So now, you remember, Isaac was the promised seed, which is a type of who?
Yahshua
the Messiah. That's why Abraham was told to offer up his son.
Right.
Type of how Yahweh would offer up his son.
Right.
See? Read on.
And this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before of Yahweh in Yahshua, the law was 430 years after, cannot disannul that it should make the promise of none effect.
So listen now, let's just make one correction here. Because many times we thought that Israel was down here for 430 years. They weren't.
No.
They're only down there for a couple hundred years.
That's right.
It was 430 years from the promise that the law was spoken though.
That's right.
You see what I'm talking? Yes. Paul corrected that. Is that right?
Yes.
So that promise was up here in Canaan's land. Is that right? But they had to go down. Is that right?
Yes.
And be a stranger in a strange land. And they were down here for only a couple hundred years.
That's true.
And then Paul is writing that this law here that was spoken down from Mount Sinai cannot disannul the promise made to Abraham to bless both Jew and Gentile in Yahshua the Messiah. How did he do that? After his death, burial, resurrection, ascension, poured out the Holy Spirit, that's the spiritual kingdom on earth, setting up that heavenly Jerusalem. Is that right?
Yeah.
In the hearts and minds of what? Mankind.
Yeah.
What does Doc have here? Baptism in the Holy Spirit, Pentecost,
yeah.
Jerusalem. Is that right? Heavenly Jerusalem.
Yes.
See? Get Revelation, we only have 5 minutes. Get Revelation 21 and 1.
Revelation 21, verse 1.
Yeah.
And I saw a new heaven and a new earth.
Okay, so John's writing, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. Read.
For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea.
That's very simple.
Yep.
Look back here. When they came out of Egypt, they passed through the what? The divided waters of the Red Sea.
Yes.
So Egypt, or the court run about here, is like unto the first heaven or first earth.
Mm-hmm.
After they came through the divided waters of the Red Sea on the third day, there is no more encounter with any more sea.
Right.
The only major body of water that they encountered was River Jordan. That wasn't a sea, it was a river.
Right.
So there's no more sea. The first heaven, first earth passed away. There's no more sea.
Mm-hmm.
Read on.
Mm-hmm.
See?
And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem.
No, see how he said he saw New Jerusalem. So now what is that? Moses went up into the mount. Yahweh impregnated his mind with a knowledge of this pattern. Is that right?
Yeah.
So now when Moses came down, he impregnates Israel's minds with the pattern, mm-hmm. a knowledge of the pattern. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And now 9 months later, here, let's have a baby.
Yes.
That's that pattern coming down by the divine vision in the heart and mind of Moses. That's heavenly, that's that new heaven, that new earth, or that heavenly Jerusalem. Is that right? Type and what? Shadow.
Yep.
Back here.
Yes.
You see? Read on.
Mm-hmm.
Keep reading.
And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from Yahweh.
Where was it coming from? He's coming from this mountain here, having a divine vision and what?
Revelation.
Is that right? Coming down. Read on.
Out of heaven.
Out of heaven. See?
Prepared as a bride adorned for her husband.
You understand what I'm talking about? Spiritual bride. And when did this happen? This was a type and a shadow back here.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
No, guess what? Galatians 4:19. My little children,
of whom I travail in birth.
Until what? Yahshua be formed in you. Is that right? So there has to be what? See, that Holy Spirit has to be, the preacher of the gospel plants that seed in your heart and in your mind. It has to germinate. Is that right? You see?
Mm-hmm.
Galatians 4:19. That's that heavenly Jerusalem.
Yes.
We're not talking about a geographical location.
Right.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yes.
See? And that's the city of truth.
Right.
See? Jerusalem shall be the city of truth. See? Read on. See?
And I heard a voice, a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of Yahweh is with man.
You see what's coming down from heaven? The tabernacle of Yahweh is with man. Read. Read.
And he will dwell with them.
Not it. So now change your pronoun. He. Is that right? He will what?
Dwell with them.
And what?
And they shall be his people.
Right, because the true pattern is Yahweh Elohim.
Yes.
You understand? This was a type and a shadow back here,
yes.
Which is as in Acts 7:44, the tabernacle of witness. Why is it a tabernacle of witness? Because witnessing to Yahweh Elohim, the only faithful and true witness.
Yes. That's right.
See, read on.
Mm-hmm.
See, read. See?
And he shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people.
And they shall be his people.
Elohim himself shall be with them and be their Elohim.
Be their Elohim. Is that right? Emmanuel. Elohim is what? With us.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yes.
Let them make me a sanctuary that I may dwell what?
Among them.
Is that right? See, he dwelt among them before he got in them. Is that right? See, after his death, burial, resurrection, I'm no longer going to be among you. I'm going to be in you.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
See, that's that heavenly Jerusalem. That's that city of truth.
Yeah.
You see, which is Jerusalem above. See.
Yep.
All right. Hope you got something out of it. All yes, praise indeed. Is going to Yahweh through your son Yahshua.
Everybody for joining us. Let's all rise for the doxology, which is taken from the last two verses of the book of Jude. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the glory of his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all time and now and forever. Let us all say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.